Am I right about that? I want my dignity. So if I call you, I am now admitting that I need you. And therefore, I'm more reluctant to admit at this moment in my life that I really need you. Now, there are times when you can get desperate, but far too often as a Christian, I should be one that will say, I will call you. Because I am the one that is going to you. So often what we say, you know, get a hold of me if you need anything. Well, baby girl, you already know I need something.
Come on, come on.
How is it then that you're now talking to me, talking about get a hold of me if you need something? The fact that we are talking says I need something.
Yeah.
I'm sitting over here in the dark and I'm lighting candles. And you talking about if I need anything. How about helping me turn my lights on? Am I making any sense here? So that's why Christ says what? He says, go. Therein lies the power. There is no power if I don't go. I must carry out that command. Notice that he says go because he wants them to be on, he wants us to be on the offense. Can you say offense? He doesn't want us to be on the defense. He says, for the very gates of hell shall not prevail. Upon this rock he shall build his church, and the very gates of hell shall not prevail. In other words, the gates of hell, that means that's trying to stop it. The church is forever moving forward. Am I making any sense? So therefore, there is a moving forward. There is an offense. Can you say offense? Now, how many of you understand that offense is better than defense? Let me help you understand that. Last night...
All right.
Last night in the NBA finals, you could see that even though Cleveland had bigs, they call them, you know, the center and a big forward, power forward, they could block the shots because they had what? Good defense. Is that not right? But they only had one man that could bring what? The offense. Not only did he have to bring the offense, he had to bring the water. He had to bring the, you know, he had to wrap himself up. I'm just saying. He had to do everything. I'm a little bothered, but I'll get over it. The Golden State Warriors Now we're not going to get through this point with that kind of reaction. The Golden State Warriors had great offense. I've never seen it in my life. All the man has to do is just come down and throw it up and it went in. I've never seen him been watching basketball all my life. I've never seen anybody that just comes about halfway in the court, throw it up, turn around and walk away, it goes in. Knock him down, it goes in. Falling away, it goes in. Throwing up his head, it goes in. It just goes in. All of them, it goes in. I'm sick of it. Now that I got that off my chest. But offense.
Come on, dude.
That's good. Now we know why the Lord always wants us on the
offense.
Woo!
That's right.
He's always telling us to go. Go. We are supposed to be on the offense. And so often what we do, we find ourselves in purple seats and we're on the defense, hoping that the game is going to come to us. The game will not come to us because he told us to.
Oh.
We will never win as the Cavaliers lost. They lost And this will not be a Cavalier Church.
Come on.
If anybody in here know what I'm talking about, I'm not going to be the only one in here on the offense. I got to have somebody in this church that's willing to get the ball and go on the
offense. Yes.
Come on, is anybody here willing to go on the offense? Church that's sitting back waiting for people who do not know the Lord to come through the door is a church that's on its way of dying. Slap your neighbor high five and says, we ain't dying, baby. Because we're going to go. Can you shout more seats?
More seats.
More souls. Because we're going.
Amen.
Come on, can I have anybody on my team in here? Anybody in here on the NLIC team in here? Anybody in here ready to put your jersey on? Anybody in here ready to go at it? Anybody in here ready to make some points for the Lord?
Yeah.
Slap your neighbor high five and says go.
Go.
Say the power's in the go.
The